Hi guys, and thank you for being interested in this tutorial, which we are going to talk about slot components. Okay, this is basically, it's only a method of working. It's not a new feature or a new functionality that Figma gave recently, but it's just a working method that sometimes makes sense to work with. Okay, so let me just show quickly what do I mean, and then I will explain exactly what is going on here. So I'm actually copying this content card, which is an auto layout that has a few slots in it, the slots that I created. And let me show you exactly, one second, let me just collapse it. Okay, so this is the card with the slot components. It has four slots in it. I can select one and let's say place images instead of that slot. I will select this one, and I will select this time the double slot. In the double slot, I will select, let's say, a text, and then I will select another text, which I will change it to paragraph. And here I will select the action bar, which I did here, and there I have kind of this one. I can actually shut off, and there I have a very quick content card, which is actually built from card with these slots. So the main idea is to know how to work. Of course, I mean, I'm pretty sure, and I am assuming that you're familiar with swapping instances ability that you do have in Figma for a long time already. So this is the main thing actually that it's based about. It's based on, more right to say. And I'm assuming you are familiar with components and variants. If you are not, by the way, this tutorial can be a bit, maybe, I don't know, confusing, or maybe a bit hard to understand. So you do have links that point you to other tutorials that are explaining more about components and variants. And it's better you get a better understanding about it before you get to that, because I think that this is a bit too much for someone who is not so familiar with components and variants and auto layout. Okay, so you do need to have, I will call it, let's say, a reasonable understanding, or reasonable, maybe it's not exactly the right word, but kind of like a not bad understanding in auto layout. You don't have to be an auto layout superman in order to understand it, but you do need to have, let's say, kind of a good understanding of how auto layout technically works, because it is based on auto layout abilities. Now, here I can give, let's say, bigger distances to make it look kind of like more fine, something like that. So you see that was created quite easy and fast. Now, the thing is that this content card actually, it has these components, which are just slots. They are kind of like, they are placeholder for other components to be swapped with. Okay, I'm just swapping this component inside here with another component. That's it. Basically, this is what it does. Okay, this is the method of working with slots. Now, of course, that the available components that you have are the ones that you have in your file, in your library, in your theme, or whatever. Here it's just a small example, because I didn't do that many components to show it with. It's just to show the logic and the technique how to do that. Okay, so I have here a slot. By the way, it's zero height. It doesn't have to be. It can be also 1 pixel height or 5 pixel height or whatever you want to do. By the way, giving something a zero height in Figma, just for you to know, I will show it for a sec. This frame, if I will give it, let's say, a zero height, you will see that it will always get to 1 pixel. But if you will write here 0.001 and enter, then it will be a zero height frame, just if you want to know how to get to that. So yeah, that's it. So the double slot, by the way, is pretty similar to this one. The double slot has two slots in it with an auto layout. Okay, and the logic of doing a double slot actually is that sometimes We want, let's say, a title and a paragraph with a different spacing, let's say more like that, with different spacing from the rest of the auto layout, okay? They do need to be, let's say, closer to each other, so it's more reasonable to put them in something like a double slot. Of course, you can make more. You can make a, let's say, slot component with one slot variant, two slot variant, three slot, four slot, five slot, where, I mean, as many as you want and need. So yeah, of course you can do that. Sorry. Or actually, yeah, I mean, you can, of course you can, or you can do them, sorry, as separate components like I did here, anywhere you seem right to do, but as long as basically it works. So let's say if I would give, just to show exactly what I meant here, if I will give this one 20 as the rest of the auto layout has, so you see that now it looks a bit weird, okay? I mean, that is the logic of why I did it with a double slot component, because now it looks a bit weird. We don't want it in the same spacing of the rest of the auto layout. And here I just gave it, let's say, 6. Okay, let's give it like a 6. And now it looks like more fine and the way it's logically needs to be. Of course, that I can change this one to the subtext, and then I will get something like that, which is cool. I mean, you just have, you know, these components with variants. And if I would want to create, let's say, let's take another one. Or let's take, you know what, let's take this one. And let's create, actually, let's give it a variant, okay? And I will call it, this is a, let's call it a 4 slots. And this one, I will, let's give it a 2 slots. Yeah, let's give it a 2 slots. Okay, so this one we will call 2 slots. Okay, so I'm gonna take this one and just place it here. And now I want to make a content card. I called it a 2 slots. Funny me, yes, it's kind of, yeah, okay, let me fix it. It looks weird. Yeah, 2 slots. Now it looks better. Okay, so yeah, so taking this one, and I will replace it, more right to say, with the text. And here I will place the images, and let's take the 3 images. Okay, cool. So you understand that basically what happens here, that these gray rectangles or squares or rectangles, they are just placeholders for real content. This is the whole idea, okay? I mean, these icons, for example, if you see the way that this component is built, so these have the swap instance property applied to them, okay? Sorry. So I can actually change here. I mean, I don't have icons in this file, but if I would have, let's say, an icon component that has, I don't know, 10 or 12 or 20 variants of different icons, that I can just swap it with a component that has icons, and it just can go here or here easily. Okay, I can just do that easily. I mean, I can double click this one and this one, and then I can just change it with the icon component. So the thing is that in Figma, don't forget that component instances, meaning child components of the master ones, you cannot just delete or change to change it with, like, you know, to be something else. So the swap instance gives you the ability to easily do that. Okay, and of course, as you see here, we can change it to 3 icons. I gave it the variants here, or it can be just 1 icon, or it can be 3 icons. It's just 2 icons. It's just an example of an action bar. I mean, of course, in your designs, you do whatever you need to and according to your design needs, okay? You can have maybe completely different action bars with different variants and so on. It's just an example that I gave to show the logic and the technique of how to work with slot components, okay? So I think that, and let's say that we do want also an action button. So let's say that I can make another variant, and let's say that we call it three slots. Okay, and a three slots, so let's make it a three slots. Let's make it another one. Yeah, it is a three slots. Now, by the way, it has a 10 pixel spacing between them in the auto layout. You can make it, of course, as any spacing that you want, as I change it here to be 20. So now let's say that I want the same thing like this one, but of course I want to do, let's say, the text, and I want here to put the let's say two images, and let's say that make this one, yeah, and let's say that the last one I want also to be a button. Okay, that would be a button. I will give it a hug, and I have a button, and of course I can make the spacing here bigger and do something like that. Or by the way, you see that here was better actually to use the two slots here. So if I would take the, sorry, I would take the two slots, the double slot, and in the double slot, actually, you see, I'm working according to my needs. And this one is a double slot, and this one is the, one second, I will give it the images. Yeah, exactly. And I will take the two images, and this one actually, the images one I don't need, so I could have used actually the two slots, but anyway, yeah, but you get the hang of it, and that's pretty cool. I mean, the changes that you can do with that, and very easily, very quickly. So when you have it all built, all you do is you add cards by slots, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to, I don't know, whatever you need. You can always add more variants to it. You can always add more instances that you can swap with, and so on. So basically, I think that it's pretty much understandable. And of course, as I said, that these are only placeholders. You need to think wide, to think that it needs to be a very general component that we can use, that everybody in the team or all the people that you are working with, or even for yourself, you can always use that for various things that you need on your screens. And it's going to be as general as possible. And of course, the content there can change very easy. I mean, you can just select these, let's say, three rectangles, and I can, let's say, use the unsplash. And let's go with presets, click on nature, and boom, we have it with images, and that's it. So that it was a placeholder actually for real content. And of course the title can change and so on. So that's pretty understandable. And I would say that, yeah, this is pretty much it. So again, the slot components is a working method. It's not a new feature, but it's a very cool method when you learn how to work with it, so you can do things like I did here quite easy. And of course, that this is a very specific example. In your designs, you can do whatever you need, and these are, as I said, these are also placeholders for icons. So I did a placeholder like that actually, and this is a placeholder for an icon, so same thing. Okay guys, I think and hope that that was understandable. If you do have more questions about it, or more kind of like things you think that I need to explain better on the slot components or any other tutorials that you want, I would be happy to make, of course. By the way, this tutorial was requested by I think MTMP, I mean, that's the name. I don't know the real name, so sorry. I mean, I can't say it because I don't really know it, but that was requested from one of the subscribers. So thank you for requesting this interesting tutorial. So this is for you and of course for everyone else. And thanks a lot for watching it. I would be very happy for your like and would be very happy if you subscribe to my channel and be aware about or be noted about new tutorials that are always coming up ahead. Thanks a lot and see you in the next tutorials. Bye for now.